In this video, I'm going to take you through making a beat from scratch in the program. I'm going to cover all the basics of what you need to know to get up and running right away to starting your beat. Check it out. So let's make a beat from scratch using Serato Studio. Let's start off with the drums first. By default, when you start a new session inside of Serato Studio, you'll be given a preloaded clean 808 drum kit ready for you to use. If you do not want to use that kit, then you can go to the library, to the drums tab, to load another kit. In the All Drums Kit crate, you can choose the genre style crate that you want to use for your drums. If you want to build a drum kit with individual drum sounds, you can preview each of the sounds before you load them into the drum deck. In the library, there's a preview symbol and volume adjustment. When the preview symbol is turned on, you can hear each of the selected sounds to help you figure out which sounds are best for your custom drum kit. Go to the BPM tab and click and drag up or down to adjust the BPM to your liking. You can also double-click on the BPM and type in the number that you want for the BPM to be. When you press return, the BPM will be set. In the drum sequencer, go to Make and choose a genre to load a preset drum pattern. Then press on the name of the genre and a preset drum pattern will be set. If you don't like the pattern, then go press the genre again until you find a preset that you like. Once you have a preset, you can make adjustments to the sound of the drums in the drum deck. For each sound, you can adjust parameters such as gain, EQ, filter, attack, release, reverse, key shift, and time stretch. You can also use effects to shape the sound of your drums, such as reverb, delay, limiter, and others. Select the drum sound that you want the effect to be on. Then select the effect and turn it on and adjust the amount for the effect. You can also add an effect to the entire kit in the drum sequencer deck by following the same steps. You can also draw notes to the drum sequence by clicking notes into the empty note slots. You can add a more natural and human feel to your drums by adding swing. Select the swing grid size and then turn the knob. You will hear the second notes of the grid swing later as you turn the knob. This is a great way to add a bit more character and feel to your drums. With the drum sequencer set, now you can add a sample to the sample deck. In the scene player, click on Add Sample to get an empty sample deck. You'll be taken automatically to the library and to the Audio Samples tab. Then go to the All Audio Samples loop crate. Then choose a genre style crate that you want to use for your sample. Then click and drag a sample into the sample deck. The sample will appear along with 8 cue points that Serato Studio has found for you. If there are cue points that you like, you can favorite them by clicking the favorite star for the selected cue point. You can press Find Samples to find more cue points to use. Once you have the cue points that you like, then turn on the metronome. Quantize is on by default, set to 1/16. If needed, you can adjust the quantize value in the dropdown next to quantize. Then press record in the sample sequencer. You'll be given a 4-beat countdown before you start to record a sequence. When finished, press the record button again to stop the recording. You'll notice that the project key has automatically been updated to the key of the first sample deck.
This means that any other sample or instrument deck added will now sync to this key. Now you can add an instrument deck to start playing an instrument. In the scene player, click on Add Instrument and an empty instrument deck will appear. You will automatically be taken to the library to the instrument tab. Then go to an instrument crate and choose an instrument that you want to use. Then click and drag the instrument into the empty instrument deck. For example, choose a bass sound. When playing notes on the keyboard, MIDI keyboard, or drum machine pads, the notes will play in the key of the sample when playing key is turned on. If you turn playing key off, then you can play the notes chromatically. Once you figure out the notes that make sense for the bass line, then press record in the instrument sequencer. You'll be given a 4-beat countdown before you can record a sequence. When finished, press the record button again to stop the recording. If you want to transpose the key of the project, you can do so by adjusting the project key. All the decks will change in key together, except for the drum decks. If you have hit a note incorrectly while recording, it's easy to click and drag the notes around the sequencer. You'll get an instant audio preview of what the new notes will sound like. To continue building the track, create a new scene. You will see the scenes at the bottom of the scene player. To add additional scenes, you can click on an empty slot and you'll be given two options. The first option is Copy, which will allow you to copy the previous scene that you were working with. Copying your scene and clearing out one or two of the sequences is a great way to create an intro or breakdown. The second option is Empty, which will give you an empty scene to start adding in decks of your choice without any previously written notes. As you make new scenes for parts of the song, like verse, chorus, bridge, breakdown, drop, or outro, you can double-click on the scene to rename it to whatever part of the song that it is. Once a new scene is made, you can make variations to the sequences or add additional drum, sample, and/or instrument sequencers to record additional parts to the track. Song structure generally repeats in 4, 8, 16, and 32 bar phrases, depending on the style of music that you're making. For example, with most hip-hop songs, the intro is generally 8 bars, the verses are generally 16 bars, the chorus is generally 8 bars, and again for the outro, it is generally 8 bars. These numbers can generally be doubled for house music and other styles of dance music. Once you have created various scenes to make up parts of your track, then you can begin to lay them out in song view. To get to song view, click the tab to the right of the library. Once in song view, you can click and drag a scene and drop it into the timeline of the song view. As you populate the song view, you can zoom in and zoom out on the timeline. In the top right corner of the song view, there are zoom in and zoom out buttons that will allow you to zoom. To play the song, press the play tab. Pressing it a second time will stop the music. You can also move the playhead along the timeline to play the song from a particular point. As you build your song, you'll notice a live updating waveform display in the master track as you play through it. This gives you a visual reference of your song, so you can see if it's too quiet, has too much bass, or just easily to identify parts of the song. You can select the master track to see an even larger version of the master waveform. This is where you can also apply mixer settings, effects, and plugins to your master track. As you do this, you will see the change in the waveform in real time. Once you have completed the song in Song View, you can go to File to Export Song. The song will be exported as a 16-bit, 44.1 kHz wave file. You also have the option to export individual files for each deck. This option can be found when clicking on Export Song in the File tab. Files will be exported as 16-bit 44.1 kHz wave files. Exporting individual files is great for taking your song and finishing it in another application, or if you need to send your song to a sound engineer to get mastered.
So that's how you make a beat from scratch with Serato Studio. Have fun creating music, and make sure you check out www.serato.com/studio to learn more.